Okay, and our last one here is going to be again, you're going to listen to the read aloud of Interrupting Chicken and the Elephant of Surprise, and you have a sequence, which means you're going to put things in order. You're going, the instructions read, watch the read aloud, copy the sentences, and number them in order that they happened in the story. Now, when we have a story, I'm going to give you an example here. We're going to do this one together. I'm going to show you this sequencing events. So I'm going to read the story. Mary was on her way to school. She always walks with Tammy, her best friend. She was almost to Tammy's house when she realized she forgot her lunch. She turned around and went back home. She walked into the house and grabbed her lunch off the kitchen counter. Finally, she made her way back to Tammy's house. Now here we have sentences that we're supposed to put in order, 1, 2, 3, and the way that they happened. So we're gonna read the first sentence. It says, Mary grabbed her lunch off the kitchen counter. The next one says, Mary realized she forgot her lunch. And the last one says, she turned around and went back home. Now this is again going back to look for text evidence and seeing where it is that we can find this. So when we see Mary grabbed her lunch off the kitchen counter, I can go back and look to see where she found, where she got her, grabbed her lunch off the kitchen counter. So here it is. So I'm going to box it, grabbed her lunch off the kitchen counter. Okay. Then the next one shows, says Mary realized she forgot her lunch. So when I go back, I can see right here, it says she realized she forgot her lunch. So I'm going to box that just so that you can see where I can find it and found my text evidence. And the last one says she turned around and went back home. Okay, well, if we go back over here, it's almost as she, oh, here it is. She turned around and went back home. So now I can look at where I found them. This seems to be first. So she realized she forgot her lunch. So I'm going to put a 1 here. Then my next sentence was she turned around and went back home. Right here. So this would be number 2. And then the last, finally, it says grabbed her lunch off the kitchen counter, and it's right there. So this would be a 3, okay? So when you put them in sequence, you put them in order that they happened, okay? Which means you can also go back and check your answers to see if you actually did that. Because sometimes you can get confused and think, oh, well, she forgot her lunch and then she turned back around. No, she turned back around and then it states in the story because she realized she had forgotten her lunch. Okay, so this is sequencing of events. So you're going to look at these sentences right here. You're going to write them down on a piece of paper, and you're going to number them just like they are here. So there's a little line there, and it says, Papa begins reading Rapunzel. Little Chicken changed the ending to the Ugly Duckling. Little Chicken wrote her own bedtime story for Papa. Papa begins reading The Little Mermaid. Papa explains to Little Chicken what element of surprise means. So these are all your sentences. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sentences that you're going to write on a piece of paper and number them in order. Remember, they're not in order right now. They are, you need to put them in order. So go back to the story. Remember where you saw that sentence. Remember where it happened and say, oh, there it is. It happened in the first page. Oh, it happened in the third page. Oh, this happened at the very end. And that'll help you figure out where your numbers go. Okay, this is in yellow, which means it is a grade, boys and girls, so good luck.